Hey up guys, it's Fishy and welcome back my glorious Bannerman to some more Mountain Blade. This is Call of Warhammer. What am I talking about? It's because I just uploaded a Mountain Blade episode, that's why. But yeah, welcome back to some Call of Warhammer. We're just going to go with this intro, no point restarting now. So yeah, welcome back to some more Call of Warhammer. Last episode, things went really, really well for us. We managed to defend our northern province. However, we were instantly under siege again, and the men of the north are hardy. But I don't know if they can withstand another assault from the Chaos armies, because there's quite a few of them here. Quite a few of them. But who knows? The Norse dwarfs could step up, and Long Dong can lead his men to victory. Fingers crossed. Down here in the south, I am also about to besiege, or hopefully take this province. I mean, we've only got three more turns before we completely starve them out. So that's good. And just reducing their numbers through starvations is always good from besieging them. So yeah, we're just going to keep on besieging them there. And then we kind of just got troops trying to move into position. We have this army over here going to try and take the last few Karaks over here. Really, I just need to take one Karak, and then I can build a stronghold there. I mean, I can build troops in that Karak and stuff, so... we're just kind of waiting for our troops to get into place. We also have some Longbeards coming in here. No, don't. Stop, stop. Please stop, please stop. Nice. Because I want to move this unit back into there to retrain. And then these Longbeards can move on to there. Lovely. Lovely, lovely, lovely. They actually have quite a few infantry units here. I'm just going to keep on spamming out Longbeards whenever I can. Actually, I should probably retrain them because they've got experience. And then, yeah, we just have troops moving, basically, from places to places. Because at the moment, we have to kind of walk so far to get our men into wherever they're going. It's quite a trek. Oh, they finally actually did take Castle Drakenhof. Nice. Hats off to the Reich for doing that. But yeah, at the moment, we're just ending our turns and waiting for the Siege of Prague, or Prague, however you pronounce that, to end. Because apparently the Chaos don't want to come help out the Chaos Dwarfs. They're a bit sizist, apparently. Even though they're like floating around, they're not actually attacking me, which I'm more than happy, because each turn we're starving them out a little bit more and killing more and more of them. For sure, their numbers are definitely going down. We'll just have a look now. Yeah, before that was like 1,200, 1,500. So we are killing some. Unfortunately, we haven't killed any Chaos Trolls, which kind of makes me a bit upset. But we've killed a lot of their infantry, starving out. We've really just started eating one another or something. Could you imagine? That's the Chaos Dwarf way, just to start eating. So here's the question. Do I just take this province? Like, I'm not sure if it has Dwarven culture. It does have some Dwarven culture, but I'm not sure because it's not really a mountain city. So I guess I won't be able to recruit from it. So I guess we just try and bypass it and then just go straight for this. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to this Karak first. I'm going to bypass this Rebel Karak, just because they have a full stack here. So I'm going to bypass it, take out the Chaos one. That does mean I will be fighting the Dark Elves, but it also means that I'll be able to actually recruit some men. Because this is obviously, I'm pretty sure this is a mountain city. So we should be able to actually recruit men from there. Yeah, that's cool though. And we just continue starving. Two more turns they've got there, that's fine with me. And then we actually just move the men into there. I might just start building. I'm obviously going to be building a second force here. All the Longbeards, which are being retrained and stuff, will meet up here, and then they'll probably take a leader, and then they'll go to go support Prince Lognar, who's off on his last campaign with Gotrek. So if I just keep on spamming out Longbeards when I can, and even Longbeard with axes can come join. I mean, I can actually get a load of Longbeard with axes here, and we'll get some hammerers. We haven't really used hammerers that much at all, really. And they're so good as well. I don't know why I haven't been using them. I need to be careful as well, though, because I'm probably going to be losing quite a bit of money. So maybe I shouldn't get both units of them. Yeah, let's just not do that. And we'll keep hold of a bit more money. Until we really take another province, we can't really afford to do that. God, we are being starved out here as well. This one man, this one Norse warrior will hold the walls. He will rally to the men. So yeah, again, we just end the turn. Like, it's like three more turns until we get to Karak Durindan. God. Warhammer's going to be an interesting way to pronounce the stuff when the game finally comes out. So, do they sally forth or... Oh, no, this is... Where is this? This is up in the north. We have to fight this for us to win. So yeah, let's go and jump in. But this shouldn't be the only battle in this episode. I'm looking to at least get two battles in this episode. or at least take some more cities. So this could be the last battle for the episode. There might only be one, but we will at least get further in the campaign. We'll at least like auto-resolve some sieges. Because if they sally forth in the Chaos Dwarf place, obviously we'll fight that. Like 100%, I want to fight that. And if they and this won't be happening because all the orcs are dead in the picture. Let's go and start deployment. So they have a siege tower, which kind of sucks. I'd like them not to have a siege tower. They have a few rams. I mean, honestly, I'm just thinking I'm just gonna fall back. Like, I just don't have the men to defend it. Like, I don't want to fall all the way back. I could fall back all the way to here, but I'm just not going to. Like, I'm gonna leave one unit over there by the gate to like enact the towers, and then everyone else is just gonna fall back. I think this is my best way of actually surviving. Can they do spikes? I don't think they can. No, they can't. That's fine though. We have axemen to do spikes. Not that they actually spikes are pointless because they don't have any cavalry. So let's go ahead and get archers up there to react that tower. Archers up there to react that tower. Probably might as well just put rangers up there as well. That'll be a nice crossfire down there. We'll put some pirates up here, but I don't know if they'll be able to shoot. Because that's all my missiles. Longbeards. Again, form shield. They might as well be my first line of defense, my longbeards. Just because they're going to be strong as hell. And then my Norse Dwarven Warriors can kind of follow up behind. With some axemen support. And some pistols overhead. That would be lovely. If these guys can shoot overhead. So I just need to bring back my individual man right now. He's gonna get involved for sure. He's gonna get involved. Whether I don't know what he's gonna do. Actually, he can come over here and actually react to these towers to make sure they're shooting. I mean, he can just run away. I might do the same with some towers over here as well. Yeah, I can react both of them towers. I don't really need to enact any of these towers, I don't think. So I can actually bring back this whole unit. What I might do as well is I might actually defend the gate like so. And actually just have a unit out here stopping them from even getting the ram to my gate. Nice. I think we're ready. That's everyone, right? Cool. So that's very good. This one soldier will hopefully help burn this ram and just slow them up and let our missiles really go to town. Look at him. He doesn't care. He's like, are you guys not entertained? Yeah, because we've actually already managed to destroy that ram, which is awesome. So we could actually destroy this siege tower as well. That will slow him up. For sure. Because these are ballista towers. I wish I would have got cannon towers here. Because they would have just racked up so many more kills. Oh, it's raining as well. No, we don't want it to be raining. We do not want it to be raining. But hopefully we start killing a few of them. We already killed up a cent. It's better than nothing. A few casualties here as well. Just need to find a really good hit. Don't know where this ram's going either. I guess they're just reforming and then they're going to try and advance. I would assume. We might get lucky though and be able to kill this in time. I guess not. I will keep hold of the watchtower though as long as I can. A few more casualties here. Actually bring him a ram out. I don't really know what the AI is doing, but that's fine with me. We're killing a few more. Killed 2% of their men. I mean, it's better than nothing. We might even be able to destroy this ram as well. Or have they just fully glitched out? There you go. They're smashing away now at my gate. I never noticed that. They're actually like crossbows, like on the towers. I never noticed that. That looks actually looks pretty cool. So yeah, we're definitely actually racking up some kills on them then. 3% now. I mean, 3% is better than nothing. It really is. Is that their general unit as well? If that is their general unit. Oh no, every unit has that dude. But that looks really cool. He looks awesome. I guess they're just going to glitch out, so I'm just going to let them come through, because I want them to be able to attack me. I don't want to have this boring battle where we just wait for like 40 minutes. And we'll fully bring these guys back as well. Stick them on guard mode. So they're just literally in this gap. That'd be awesome. Yeah, so let's charge out because it's clearly just glitching and I don't want it to... Yeah, so let's actually do that because at least this way the burning oil as well racks up some kills. So if I stick them on guard mode, they might actually be able to hold it for a little bit. I mean, I just need to get this one Dwarven Warrior out of there. I mean, if he has to fight there, he has to fight. Because look, this burning oil is killing a lot of them. Run, dude! Run! Get out of there! Dude, run! Fall back! Fall back! Seriously, if he can get out of there, I will be over the moon. Did he get stuck or is he still going? Where is he? Oh, yeah, she got down. No! Run, Dwarf! Run! He's making a run for it. He is 100% making a run for it. So my archers are now shooting, which is good. But he should hopefully be able to rack up some kills on these troops. You can already see the casualties they're withstanding. Because these guys aren't really that heavily armoured. Yeah, there you go. That's another volley from my men. Get out of there, dude. You just come up this way, you'll be fine. God, I feel like naming this, one dude, I'm just never going to retrain him. And this is going to be Pixelated Apollo right here. This is his dwarven twin right there. He's now named the Pixelated Apollo and he will hold the dwarven... lands. Oh, they're actually shooting or not? It sounds like they are. Are any of them shooting? A few of them are. That's good. At least a few of them are. I need to make sure I'm shooting like more efficient targets, like more bigger units. Because what, we managed to kill 16% of them. That's pretty good. Oh god, they're bringing up ladders though. That's not so good. My men better be ready to start fighting. Why just bring up this unit of warriors? Oh yes, the miners are going out now as well. Yes, it's a massacre. God, he managed to get out. Thank God. Let's bring him back where he's nice and safe. I will keep him safe. I mean, them ladders aren't going to be too bad anyway, because they're coming up against my warriors anyway. So I managed to get the ladders up, and that was about it. And these guys over here are going to be meeting my pirates, so they're fine. They're ready. Cool, let's start shooting into this big bulk. We get some bombs out, boys. A few bombs down there, just protecting my men. If we can kill that group, that'll be good. We just need to keep on shooting into their big bulks of infantry. I've actually run out of ammunition on this unit, which kind of sucks. We need to reform just a little bit. And we also have our swordsmen here. Just chilling. So yeah, because they don't really have any like elite troops, so their morale is just going to be pretty appalling this battle. And we've managed to reduce our casualties pretty nicely, I think. Yeah, they're just all routing, which I guess is good for me. They're scared of my Dwarven Warriors. Which is good, because it just means my miners can just go to town. Continue up the missile fire here. Where are they going? Oh no. Oh no, boys. What are you doing? They've come down to meet them. I guess they can reform behind them. Yeah, that'll be good. Oh my god, all my men. What are all my archers doing? I mean, they'll be able to rack up some kills here for sure. But I don't know why my rangers came out to fight. Can we shoot on the side of these guys? Along with Merlin's mines, that should be able to slaughter them. Nice, got them to route. Why are all my men coming down? I have no idea. Why are my miners coming down? I guess because what they're trying to shoot comes out of range. I guess that's why they've done that. But it's still a bit annoying. I've actually muted my sound as well. And that's also weird when it does that. But that's been a kingdom's bug for some time. So I'm actually going to bring my dwarfs out a little bit and actually help my men out there. I'm almost just letting them come through my gate, but I think that's fine. Get back up there, boys. There's a lot of stuff for you guys to be shooting at. Get these archers out of the way. Yeah, I need him to be shooting like that massive bulk there. Ideally. I think he's going to be struggling a little bit. Let's bring him forward a little bit. Maybe then he'll be able to get at least some mines in there. Yeah, my rangers did not stand a chance, but that's understandable. I like the way my longbeards have lined up as well. They're a nice, tightly knitted group as well. The gate's open. That's how little our dwarfs care. They're just like, bring it. I almost dare you guys to come and attack me. That's what they're like. There's hardly any of them left. There's only killed half of them already. Don't know why they're bringing up a... Oh, them bomb hits. Don't even know why they're bringing up a siege thing. They can walk through anyway. Which they do. And then they just come straight onto burning oil. Hold your ground, boys. Stick them on guard mode. Tell them just to hold their position. The oil should do the rest. And we also have mines coming over the top as well. Oh, look at them. That's just devastating. Got some Dwarven warriors out here. If they can rout these guys and actually flank them, that'd be pretty good. Yeah, push back dwarves. We're even pushing them back now. The strength of Dwarven steel. Look, we're actually pushing them back, and there's so many more of them than there are of us. That's Longbeards for you. Look at the oil just burn them. Look at the cowards run. And good old Pixie over here is just like, yes, I'm a part of this. Yeah, look at them. We're actually chasing them out. It's just this big bulk here which is left. A few of them are... Oh, crap. They're actually going back, which I guess makes sense. I don't know why I didn't think they wouldn't come back. They can just shoot what they want, though, the miners. I mean, it's probably best to stick the miners over here. I don't know. Bring down the Long Dong pirates, though. Long Dong has done it. He's managed to hold off against another siege in the north. He just needs to hold off until I've taken the rest of the Karaks, and then I will send support for him, I think. But until then, he's kind of on his own a bit. I mean, these Norse dwarfs as well held off. Like, they were fighting like 3 or 4 units, so hats off to them. Yeah, look at that death. There's only a few long-beard bodies there. Mainly just the enemy. I think they have maybe one unit of infantry left, which is just this. So as soon as we route this. Okay, this one last one over here. So yeah, it was a pretty successful battle. We have our crossbowmen going in. They actually look like more badass than my Norse dwarf warriors, just because they have like these massive two-handed weapons. I mean, I actually managed to rout them as well, which just makes it look even cooler. What is even left? That's a battle, right? Like, what is left? Nothing, right? Oh, they have their general's unit, which I need to go kill. Let's do that. So let's go speed things up. I'll probably speed things up in post-production now as well, so you guys don't have to sit through this painful run. So yeah, I'll see you guys at the end of the battle. I've got a nice little expedition here of my dwarfs going out. Like, they've just kind of walked outside the cities to go clear out any rabble which is left. There's another ram. Run through the ram. If they can. And we're going to, yeah, this looks really cool. It looks actually really, really cool. They're just a nice little expedition. Running out, going to deal their damage. Especially with their capes as well. Their fur capes just look really cool. It's like we're actually marching out to go on a little patrol. Oh, we need to silence these heretics. Purge the heresy. That's what we need to do. Because they are being very noisy. This is a really nice castle as well, looking at it. A really nice castle. Oh lord, that hurts my ears. Cool, gonna continue it just in case I kill my general. Okay, I didn't kill my general, but that's fine. See, it's 183 men and we killed 1400. That's good. We need battles like that up in the north for sure. Because what's probably going to happen now is we're probably going to go ahead and get besieged again up in the north. So we won't even have a turn to replenish troops or anything. It'll just be an instant attack straight away. Obviously, we will execute the prisoner scum. So yeah. Oh, we didn't. Yes. So we actually get a turn of replenishing in the north. That means I can recruit some more units. That's very good for us. Very, very, very good. I guess we do that, but I might as well just take this, right? Like, it's on the way. I can always just give this to someone. Ooh, they actually have a unit of Chaos Ogres there. Wow. Shout out to them. I'm actually going to save the game, auto it, and then if it's really bad, I'll just fight it myself. That's pretty bad, but I can't really be able to go fight that battle for that worst of a battle. Let's go and sack the city. And we'll destroy all the... Are these actually all elven buildings? Would I be able to recruit? I could recruit... I can actually recruit... Oh yeah, I can recruit Goldfang's mercenaries now, can't I? Awesome. Okay, I can't actually recruit men of my own, so I'm probably just going to give this to someone. Destroy all the buildings and give it to someone, I think. So if you've got headphones in, probably turn it down for the next 5 seconds. I mean, I don't really need the money now, so I might just give this to the high elves. Start building roads there, just in case I do keep hold of it. Where's my diplomat? Can I reach the high elves now? I can. So what's it called? We'll move my army out. Merge them up first, because they're already pretty fully strengthened. And let's go ahead and give this to the elves. So let's just double check what's called. It's just an elven fortress. Nice. Because they should get men here anyway. So let's go ahead and give them a region. Elven Fortress. It is a gift, good friend. It is a gift. So then they automatically get some men here. They should get some High Elf Spearmen, which aren't half bad. Which are not half bad at all. They look really cool as well. So they can use that and we'll just push on. Because we have men coming. These Longbeards are coming to reinforce. It's just going to take them a couple turns. So we just need to go ahead and take the Karak over here. Next turn we'll be able... Well, yeah, next turn we starve these guys out, even though they are very depleted already. Good job. So we need to make sure we spend money up here. I mean, we might as well start building the cannon tower. Well, we might as well start building this, right? 4 turns, but, you know, we might get 4 turns of not being attacked. So what do I need to replenish? I need to replenish you. Oh, did Apollo die? It's not here anymore. It must have got rid of him. Wow, how sad. R.I.P. Apollo. So let's go and replenish them. And then probably just build some new units, right? Some fresh men. Maybe some more crossbowmen. Yeah, that seems perfect. I don't think I merged these men. No, I can't have merged these men, so... R.I.P. So Longdong actually got some new stuff, I think. Oh, he didn't actually. He just got some new traits, which is fine. I'll probably build some better roads after that, just so we can get men up to the north more effectively. And we're currently just building Longbeards, right? Up here, we have a few. I guess we're just going to keep on, when we have Longbeards, we're just going to keep on moving up to this province. It'll be a good supply province. I guess this is very uncharacteristic of my dwarves as well. We actually gave a province to the elves. But I think it will help us out in the long run. That'll be like, that's just a nice province, I guess, for them to have. So they siege us again, but I think I'm 90% sure we get our reinforcements and our men we recruited and the men we retrained. I'm pretty sure we get them before anything else. So they actually sally forth, which is fine with me, I think. I mean, honestly, I feel like I just want to. I can just retreat. I don't have to fight this. There's like no rush. I mean, I just besiege him again. Because look how many men they lost. 7 turns, and then just starve them out again. They lost all the chaos. They haven't lost the chaos trolls, but they lost like a large portion of their men. So I'm gonna just starve them out again, retreat and starve them out. There's no rush. And if this army wants to come and attack me, I'm okay with fighting an army on like several fronts. I can just form a nice dwarven box and we'll be absolutely fine. Until we can get this battle nice and auto-resolving. And we'll just. I mean, we could do it now, but I just don't want to risk this army. Because this army has to make its way all the way up here and take this Karak. Oh, we can actually reach this province as well. Nice. Some Chaos Ogres, which are pretty scary. But everything else is fairly fine. So let's just go ahead and leave that siege. At least until these Longbeards have got here. I think. So that's another turn. So next turn we will attack. We have ogres of our own. A bit of starvation would be nice. It will kind of hurt them. They do actually have some really nice units in this army. But I don't think it'll be enough. Some shield maidens as well. They look cool. Obviously we have to be careful that the dark elves don't come and attack us or anything. Because we are in range of them now. That's all good though. That is all good. We also should probably go take this province as well. Oh crap, I did not mean to end the turn. But we did nonetheless. We did nonetheless. So yeah, ideally we just kind of want to wait. So this is kind of what I would want to happen. I wanted this to happen because I'd much rather fight this army out in the field. Because what the army attacking me is awful. Like, these extra men would not change. Like, that doesn't account for having wolves. A couple hundred men. So I'd much rather kill this army out in the army open. Oh god, berserkers are scary. I need to kill them. And obviously the chaos. Yeah, the chaos ogres we need to slaughter. We have cannon, we have mortar. If my mortar's just shot shooting the berserkers straight away. We should be fine. So cool, let's go and jump into this battle. And if we win this battle, we take one of the Karaks, which are pretty vital to our winning of this campaign. Then there's only two more provinces we need, and then we'll be away, basically. So let me know down below in the comments what faction you want me to play next. I'm probably going to have a vote, but it still doesn't hurt for you guys just to let me know what faction. Because I'm like probably more likely to play the factions you guys tell me in the comments beforehand. Oh lord, this map. Oh lord, this map. Oh, look at them. Jesus, we're on the side of a mountain, that's for sure. So I guess we just make our way up here and then we just hold the high ground. Can we even get up here? We can't even get up here, so I guess we go all the way down here. Are we just stuck? Like, can we not go anywhere? Are we just stuck on the mountain? Is this battle just glitched out? I guess it is. So we'll go ahead and reload it. I guess I can move my men a bit. Nah, cool. Just go and just exit the battle. We'll reload the autosave. And hopefully it will work this time. Maybe, I mean, if it doesn't, then I guess I can just retreat. Because I don't really want to have to auto-win this battle. Because it's quite an important battle. So it's fine. If they want to just glitch out, what I will do... let's go and load that autosave. Lords the autosave. Yeah, and I mean, if they want to be annoying, then it's fine. I'll just retreat and attack the army and make them come to me. Because I don't want to have to auto-win attack out of this battle. Because this is a pretty important battle. So, where are we? Are we still besieging it? We are. Good. So, they should probably attack me again this turn. Just need to make sure that there's nothing I haven't not done. Nice. We're restarving out this faction. We should be able to take them out fairly soon with Murden. These guys are moving next turn. Cool, let's just get in the turn again. And hopefully, fingers crossed, it doesn't glitch us out again. But it's not the end of the world if it does. Like, we can still fight that battle. I'll just have to retreat a little bit and then re-engage myself on a more favourable battle. So they attacked us again, so we'll jump into the battle. I guess I could withdraw. But I didn't really want to. Like, that's what we'll withdraw if this battle messes up again. But it might put us in a different place this time. I don't know if that's really how Total War works, though. Like, I think you're kind of in the same position every single time. But it might allow us to move our men this time. So, can I move anyone? No, is it just going to be glitched? Yeah, I think it is just going to be glitched this entire time. It's actually quite a cool battlefield as well. It's very, very, very vast. Yeah, so just go and load the autosave, and then when they attack me, I'll just retreat. I think that's the best way to do it, really. Nice, Skaven. We actually fought. If you actually missed our Mountain Blade episode, I uploaded like yesterday or a day before yesterday, then we fought a lot of Skaven, like a hell of a lot of Skaven. So make sure to go watch that because they have some really cool shields and stuff. So let's go and load the autosave one last time. And then when they attack us, we'll just retreat, and then that'll be that. God, these chaos are pretty scary. I wouldn't like to come across these guys. With like hands and just rats coming out of them. They're pretty scary. So cool, let's go ahead and end the turn. And when they attack us, we will retreat. I think that's the best way to do this. And then if they want to attack us again, they're more than welcome to. But if not, we'll just go re-siege the city, but probably from a different angle, I think. Or if we just attack the army that attacked us, because that'll be outside the city. So obviously we'll retreat. And if they want to attack us here, that's fine. It should be a different battlefield. Yeah, we have a few more armies involved. Just another 150, but that's fine. Cool, let's go and jump into this battle. And fingers crossed it works. Fingers crossed. Like, there's a fairly big open field, so we should be okay. Oh, it's nighttime as well. Yes, I mean, it looks like the battlefield is perfect. Perfect to slaughter some enemies. So I'm probably just going to go up against this hill. Like, I feel like having this mountain to my back will be my best chance because the enemy will be coming from like every angle. Oh, we can also put our artillery up here. That's amazing. That's going to be so good for us. Oh, I probably should get rid of that one unit of smaller. Just have a nice line of warriors. Have some of these guys. We might as well build spikes here if we can. Because if I can get my artillery up here, which I can, wow, this is going to be a slaughter for them. Some Norse dwarfs over here as well, just backing up our lines. Some dwarven warriors backing up the lines just in case they're needed. We have our ogres back here as well to cause some havoc. God, this is going to be a sick battle. I'm looking forward to this. These hammerers have golden experience as well. Nice. We just lack like kind of missiles in this army. That's about it. We've got Gotrek and Prince Lochner. And then we've got a few more Axeman units. God, don't think I'm going to be able to deploy all of this. Like that. Yeah, that seems good. Oh, we might as well just do that. Yeah, that seems good. So we seem like we're fully formed up. We have missile superiority. Oh, their reinforcements are actually kind of far away. So we could have actually just taken advantage of that and actually killed their men first. But this is an awesome battle. Look how dark it is. It's thundering. Let's bring these mortars forward a little bit. We have a nice little placement for our mortar pit. God, this looks cool as hell. As soon as the enemy get close, we are going to unleash hell on them. The rain just hitting off my men's shields and stuff. You can see their reinforcements coming in. This is going to be an epic battle. The rain changing direction, cool. Oh, I'm looking forward to this. They're probably just going to wait for their reinforcements to get here, because it is quite a distance away. But they're just about to get here as they march through the mountain pass. But my men can wait, we're patient. Our ogres are probably getting a bit cold though. They're like, can we get into battle? Whereas our dwarves are just ready. Like, I just can't wait for battles like this in actual Warhammer Total War when it comes out. Just like these epic battles where I have like, I've kind of backed into a corner with a dwarf, I have all my artillery shooting, I have my gyrocopters just going around behind, harassing the enemy forces. This is going to be so much fun. So much fun. Okay, cool. I'm going to speed this up until we actually get into the battle, so I'll see you guys when the battle is ready. Okay, guys, so we are back. The hordes are finally here. The reinforcement army is coming, and we've opened up with our artillery. Our artillery is now shooting away on our nice little position. Oh, can they actually get up here? They can actually run up here. Cool, so we actually need to send a good thing I noticed that. Wow, that was actually very convenient. See, I don't know if they can. I guess they can through here, right? So if we just send a unit of infantry to start, I mean, we don't even have to do it. I'll keep an eye on it. I'll keep an eye on if they're coming closer or not. But yeah, you can see our artillery going out. Wrecking up. I definitely want to kill these Chaos Dwarfs first, because they're going to be sturdier than just these basic Marauders. And obviously this cavalry as well we want to kill. We did have a few shots off on the men over here with our mortar, because our mortar's actually in range of this, which is something I didn't know. Cannons away, boys. Hopefully we find some direct hits here. Oof. Oh, yeah, some very nice direct hits. If only I had archers as well, that'd really complete off this comp, this army comp. So I'm just going to change focus and try to kill their general, because he's really the only thing I'm worried about, is the heavy missile from the general. Because their infantry is not really going to be a problem for my infantry. These are longbeards. These are no mindless dwarfs. They are born and bred to fight. This is their purpose. I just can't wait to see Iron Breakers as well. Thinking about it, Iron Breakers will be so epic in Total War Warhammer. Like, can you imagine them just like, they're born to defend the depths of the Dwarven Tunnels against the Orc Marauders. They don't see daylight. Ever. Like, that's awesome. They're going to be so epic. Oh, some more mortar shots. Can we find any more hits on their general? Oh, so actually we got some really nice hits. Nice, just keep on wounding them. I don't really know what this other army's doing. I guess it's waiting for everyone to turn up, but oh well. Yeah, we don't want to let them through there. Stop them, please. Oh, I guess we're going to get a little bit... Oh, good, we just managed to stop them. And I can always just move these dwarfs in to go help out as well. So let's go and just charge. Start fighting. Their generals come in a bit, so we do actually need to change focus with our missiles. We don't want to be... Oh, Lord, was that my own missiles? If that was my own men, I am very sorry. I think it was as well. God, I just killed so many of my own men. Let's just change focus away from our own men. Don't want to... Oh, that's actually a really nice hit from wherever hit it. So let's slow things down as well. We don't want to be playing in 2x speed. Charge forward, dwarfies! Charge forward! So yeah, we should be able to, you can see, we routed one of their men just so easily at the moment. We should be able to clean this up, and then the rest of the time our artillery can just keep on shooting at their army over here. Whilst we capture all these chaos scum. The general's coming in for another attack. Might as well pop our rage now, because really we're not going to have another time to use it, so we might as well use it now. Just try and capture the rest of these dudes running. Oh, these are actually halberdiers as well, so this infantry routing is actually pretty good. We must have done a good job at killing them. We need to go and make sure we try and kill these Dwarven Chaos Dwarfs there, because they're gonna be very strong. These Demons of Shalesh as well. I can't believe how many men I killed. Look at them. R.I.P. all these dwarfs. Completely my bad. And we're still just shooting away at them then. Like, our mortars should be having a field day, really. Kill them, back cavalry. 14 of them left. This is when I need more missiles to kill the cavalry. I guess a few of their men have just glitched out. Ooh, their reinforcements are coming now. I guess we can reform. Reform a line. Reform a line! Slow things down once more. Obviously, we need to be very careful with what we're shooting with our cannons. But all these men are just routing already. So we like to see. Scared of my dwarven might. Like over here probably needs some help. Like, oh yeah, I would say over here definitely needs some help. I'm just going to tell my missiles just to hold fire now. They don't need to be shooting. If these guys can get around the flank as well and help out, that'd be amazing. But really, oh, let's bring up the ogres as well. What the hell? Oh, the chaos ogres over here. They're not. Where are the chaos ogres? I swear they should be somewhere. Prince Longner and Gorik will get up now and get ready to fight some people. So my line's a bit spread now. We still have quite a few warriors just chilling around though who can definitely get involved. We'll pop our second rage now. I totally forgot I even had that. The ogres are in as well. Awesome. The ogres should be racking up some kills. Look at them all out. Awesome. The ogres are actually pretty good at chasing down people as well. That's awesome. They can actually chase people down. Keep it up, ogres. Yeah, they're doing a very good job at chasing down the enemy. Prince Logner's currently fighting out of their general unit. I think that's pretty much just battle one now. They don't really have much left. I can see anyway. Everything I can kill, I pretty much have. Apart from their general unit, obviously, which is just being frustratingly annoying. With his one man left. Well, the ogres have found some more people to fight. They've lost one ogre, I think, but we should hopefully be able to retrain them soon. And their general's dead now. That should rout everything else. We just have that heavy one heavy cavalry unit to kill. And then the rest should really be, which is here. Which we should hopefully be able to kill. Kill him, take him down, Legolas. Nice. So that should rout everything else now. The chaos shouldn't stand. And the good thing is we're just killing their general. Killing their generals are actually really important. I've found anyway. Go find some more of the enemy scum. What's even left? Is there some men glitched out up here? They have one unit glitched up out here, which I can't even attack. But maybe if I run some units through them or something. So let's bring up Prince Lochner. We'll bring up the artillery just in case, but hopefully I don't need to use them. And then Prince Lochner's... I mean, the time's probably going to run out before I even get up there. I guess this is what was glitching out the other army, I guess. Maybe if I bring up my Chaos Trolls, or my just Ogres, they'll actually... They'll be able to get up there in time. Who knows? Because they obviously just, like, glitched out on a rock or something. But if I run a unit, like, through them, maybe I'll be able to attack them. Or at least just get them unglitched. God, these hammerers actually took a pounding. They were fully strengthed. Obviously, you're up against a mighty foe. So I might just about get up here before the battle ends with my dudes. Yeah, there you go. I mean, we'll continue the battle and just clean up the rest of these dudes, just because why not? I guess it's a bit of an unfair fight, but I'd rather kill these guys than not. Ooh, we also captured 300 people exactly. That's kind of cool. Well, Prince not going to do the same as well. They're not fighting back, so... But oh well, that's their problem. Not mine. Like, one unit's not going to make much difference. So I might as well just kill it and get the extra kills. Especially now Prince Logner's involved. Their numbers are dropping very quickly. Bring my men back through it now as well. That was almost over anyway, so... I feel like we have that much longer to do. So we might as well just... Ah, oh, there's so few of them now. Let's just end the battle. So we lost 216 and we killed like 1400. So that was a good battle. We were just in such a sick defensible position. Like, with artillery up on that ridge, it just could open up on the enemy. And we also had, you know, both our flanks secure. And yeah, that was just a really, really nice battle for us. And we pretty much killed all the garrison as well, so we should just next time just be able to besiege that and just auto-resolve the Karak. But I don't see why we wouldn't be able to do that. And we also have some longbeards to go meet up with the rest of the men. So we might as well do this, auto-resolve. Like, not even now. Not even. How about if we throw these guys into the fray? Oh, they can't quite. So next turn. So next turn we should be able to take that. I think it's just because my men are very depleted. And maybe a few more full strength units to actually take it. Because I don't really want to risk it. I don't really want to fight it. Again, we just continue to starve them out here. They must be losing numbers very quickly. Very, very quickly. How are we doing over here? Oh, cool. We're actually besieging these last few provinces as well. Huzzah. Nice. Each province they take will be awesome. They have so many men there. Actually, we'll go ahead and look at the border prince. Yeah, he has so many men. Sylvania are back, though. Sylvania are back. They don't have any territory, though. Oh, they do. Do they? No, Sylvania don't have any territory, but they're just roaming hordes, basically. I guess that's what they are. I mean, the border prince should be able to kill them with all that. Don't see why he wouldn't be able to. Some nice music as well to end it. Cool, I'm going to end the episode here. I would say like 5 episodes maybe max left, because we're about to take this and then we only have to take these last 2 provinces to win the game. Yeah, we've met all the other requirements. Oh no, dominate, hold region, 16 regions. Yeah, that's it, there's no timer. So all we have to do is hold these last 2 regions and we win. And our High King, the Merciless, awesome. Greatest General is our Slayer King. Ungrid, who is also not the Slayer anymore because for whatever reason he's someone else became elected Slayer King, which is kind of weird. Oh, this is going to be an interesting battle at Karak Dun yesterday. Next episode for sure. And my mouse has stopped working as well. So cool, I'm going to go and end the episode here. I hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you guys next time. And fish out.